President Marcos, meanwhile, addressed the UN General Assembly, the first Philippine leader to physically attend the summit in 8 years. In his speech, Marcos expressed optimism. The Philippines can be moderately prosperous by 2040. Marcos said that target can be achieved through steady investments in food security, public health, education, and social services. The president also confident the Philippines remains on track in reaching the upper middle income status by next year, despite challenges brought by the pandemic and geopolitical tensions.
As we awaken from the economic stupor caused by the pandemic, we must reinvigorate the world economy. We must use public and private resources to encourage the expansion of trade, investment, and technology transfers to accelerate development. Knowledge and intellectual gains must flow freely to allow those lagging behind to catch up. Sustainable development will be hampered to the detriment of all if existing structures in the global economy remain unreformed.
When it comes to food security, Marcos underscored the need for measures that will ensure a modern and resilient agricultural sector.
We need to take concrete steps towards a modern and resilient agriculture. For food is not just a trade commodity, nor is it just a livelihood. It is an existential imperative and a moral one. It is the very basis of human security. To attain food self-sufficiency and security, we are providing innovative solutions and financial support to farmers and fisherfolk to adapt new technologies and connect to national and global value supply chains. We look forward to forging cooperation with the UN and our partners to boost agricultural productivity and food security.
Still at the UN General Assembly, President Marcos also made a bid for the Philippines to join the UN Security Council. In making his appeal, Marcos cited the country's success in peace efforts in Mindanao. Marcos also noted the possible negative effects of widening geopolitical tensions, issues in the international politics landscape. He also warned about the threat of nuclear weapons.
Our continued solidarity will also benefit from a reformed and more inclusive Security Council and an empowered General Assembly that can hold the Council to account. At the same time, the United Nations must forge ahead with its flagship tradition of global peacekeeping. My country's experience in building peace and forging new paths of cooperation can enrich the work of the Security Council. And to this end, I appeal for the valuable support of all UN member states for the Philippines' candidature to the Security Council for the term of 2027 to 2028. Our success in the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao in the southern of south of the Philippines is a centerpiece of these efforts.
A foreign policy expert sees nothing wrong with President Marcos not explicitly mentioning the West Philippine Sea issue during his address before the UN General Assembly. Professor Renato De Castro says, although subtle, the president's emphasis on the importance of a rules-based international order was enough to get his point across.
The dispute resolving mechanism of the UNCLOS, which is of course arbitration, and he did not mention it, the fact that he said that we relied on this institution. Of course, everyone knows what happened after we applied that mechanism. We won that case. You need not mention it. You don't need to embarrass or put China on the spot in the United Nations General Assembly.
Manila has been locked in a maritime dispute with Beijing. China has ignored a 2016 Hague ruling, which invalidated its historical claims in the West Philippine Sea.